Hi, Jeff Burke here from Broadband Forum. We're here in Milan, Italy for our Q3 meeting. I'm here with work area directors walking through what's been going on here at the meeting and where their work areas are going in the future. I'm here with the Phi TX work area director, Herman Verbuchen. Hello.
Hello. Nice to be here, Jeff.
Yes, I think you've had a very busy week here. Maybe first, let's talk a little bit about what Phi TX is, and then maybe let's chat about what's been happening over the course of this week.
Yes, okay. So in order to get the data, the internet to your house, you have to pass through several layers of technology. You have the highest layer, which is the application, and then you go down and down to the physical layer, where really the bits and the bytes are moved around the network. And the physical layer transmission work area, we are defining how this lowest layer operates and how the equipment can interoperate with each other on that level.
Good. Well, I think that lays the foundation then for us with regard to what Phi TX is. What's been going on actually leading up to this meeting and here in Milan this week?
Yes, so this week we had a very exciting meeting. We were able to finalize the last work on VDSL. So we're hoping to get a closure on that project. So what we have done is we have defined the test plans for the latest edition, which is long-reach VDSL. Long-reach VDSL enables you to greatly improve the distance, the reach of VDSL, allowing new scenarios for operators. They can do more, and they can use this technology to replace the old legacy ADSL. So this opens a complete new possibility for operators to start migrating their networks to more recent technologies.
Sure. So basically making more use of that copper.
Yes, right. So additionally, we have also been working on extensions of the GFAST certification. So we have been adding one of the latest profiles, the 106B profile, which has higher power and higher reach, also for the GFAST technology. We have closed all the technical review of those documents, and we can go for the final approval of this document.
It's always interesting. I think a lot of the industry focuses on the latest and greatest in terms of what people can do over fiber, and yet a significant portion of the spend as well as the infrastructure has to make use of what's already there, right?
Yes, copper has been declared dead already a lot of times, but it stays alive. Why? Because you always have to go that last mile to the customer. So fiber, you can bring fiber closer and closer to the home, which is very good, because mm-hmm. there you get also the higher speeds, but you have to cross that last mile. And the technologies, the copper technologies like GFAST, VDSL, are doing that. So that gives you the solution to just cover and get into the house.
Sure. And there's those limitations in terms of buildings that can't necessarily be easily reached with fiber. And MDUs end up being a pretty broad use case.
Yes. So this means bringing the fiber into the basement of a house, but then from the basement to the apartments. This is typically still done with copper. Mm-hmm. And all those newer technologies like MGFast, which is the successor of GFast, will enable you to bring also the gigabit speeds that the fiber brings to the basement, bring that gigabit speed to your home.
Sure. Well, we're already seeing some of that gigabit speeds and some of the technologies that are already you've already been doing some work on. Let's talk about where we go from here. So you had a busy week, tied some things up, and now as we look through the rest of 2020, what's going to be happening in Phi TX?
So in the rest of 2020, we are more targeting on GFAST technology. So there we are defining additional certification. So we are going to add certification of discontinuous operation, dynamic time assignment. We're going to work on defining the accuracy of test parameters, which is important for operators to diagnose the quality of their network. Then we're also going to define the performance targets for GFAST so that an operator knows if he deploys GFAST what performance he will get out of his system. So there also we are moving. We're doing the technical review, enabling us to then plug in those target performance numbers and so that they have a tool to know, okay, my system will do this speed, and they can be certain of this.
Well, copper seems very much alive and and well and kicking in your area of work. So, congratulations on all the accomplishments this week.
Thank you.
It looks like you have a busy slate for coming up here this fall.
Yes, thank you very much, Jeff.
Well, Herman, thank you very much for talking with me today. This is Herman and Jeff signing off from Milan. Thank you.